Hello and welcome to Alteryx Desktop Automation. So we're just going to go through here showing you how to schedule, what can be scheduled, and just the different options available to you on the Alteryx Desktop platform. This is Alteryx Designer running on a virtual machine in the Azure platform, giving you that extra bit of stability in terms of the infrastructure in the background. So let's get into it and let's have a look. If we look at the options menu here, we can see we've got our view schedules. We'll just start here for now. This is where we show our workflows that are actually in the scheduler or have been used on the scheduler. You can see various bits of information about them as well. See how many the schedules, the results that are there, and where the source file that was used for this. In this case, this was run from the scheduler DB, but we'll get into that a little bit afterwards when we're scheduling something. If we have a look across the top here, we can see our schedules tab. And here again, you can see the information about the workflows that have been on, it was put on there. Again, we can see in this case, when the frequency was, when it was last run, how it was run, where it was run from. Again, that's just all useful information, especially when you've got multiple schedules running. The queue across the top is more around when you have multiple schedules running, and if you have multiple workflows running around the same time, this is where you'll see things get queued up as they wait to in turn to run on the desktop engine. Finally, we have our results tab. So here you've got the quick color coding for the results, so you can see at a glance how successful this was. So you can see the green here with success, the warnings or conversion errors here in the yellow, amber, and the errors in the red. So if you actually click onto the plus, we can see a bit of more information here. There were errors when running the workflow, when it was run, when it was originally created, and how long it ran for, etc. If we look at the output here, we can actually see the messages as you would do with a normal Alteryx Designer. You can see the errors that were actually generated here, and in this case it was because we had a test tool put on there with an expected result of zero records, and we actually had 25 coming through there. So it was an enforced error, but it just highlights the fact that you can pick out the errors there on the workflow. So if I just come out of there, and if we come out of here for now, if we go back to the options menu, we've just got a standard customer transactions demo here. It's very low key, just joining two data sets together and outputting to two different files. So if we go to options, and we can go to schedule a workflow. As you can see here, we have the option of where the controller is, and in this case, it's on my computer. So at the top, we have a couple of options. So we can run the copy of the workflow store and store it in the scheduler DB. The database is a SQLite database, so able to be interrogated if you choose to. Or we can run the workflow from its original location. If you do that, then you just have to be mindful of updating the workflows in those locations, as any changes there will be reflected in the schedule that you produce. But you know, that is also as a benefit as well, potentially, that you can update easily without coming back into the scheduler itself. But for now, we'll run this as it's stored on the database. So on the frequency side of things, we have a number of options. So we can do the run once, as you've seen on some of those ones that I've already done, where you can choose your date as to when you want to run it using a simple date picker, and then specifying the time on that day when you want it to run. The next option down is you can specify by starting when you want to start the workflow and what time you want to do this, and how much you want it to repeat in either minutes or hours and minutes. And at the end there, you can specify when you want this schedule to stop running. The next option down is for days or weeks. So you can choose here what days of the week you want to run on and at what time. And then we have the option for months here. So you have a number of options for the day of the month. So using right from first right down to last, but you also have second to last and third to last. You can also change whether that's day or potentially the first Sunday in a month or the first Monday in a month, depending on what your requirement is. Again, you can specify when the workflow will stop running or the schedule. Finally, you have the custom option, so you can choose the time, the date, and the particular days of the month that this runs on, including the last day, and then you've in particular you can choose the months as well. So you can be quite specific in your schedules on this one. In this case, I'm just going to look at scheduling a daily workflow, but I'll make it for work days, so take out for Saturday and Sunday. And if I just specify that for 12 p.m., so run at midday, and I'm going to run it from the database. So if I just click on OK, that now is scheduled. So if we go back to our view schedules, you can see now I have an extra workflow on here generated on today. This is the workflow we've just added in. It's got one schedule. It's running from the database. But if we actually look at the schedules, now you can see again, this one is now active, whereas the others were completed. So this is an active schedule now. And if we click into here, you can see the details of the frequency and to see the different options that's happening there. Obviously, we don't have any results yet for this, but at this point, we could, if we wanted to, click on here, but we could actually edit the schedule here. So from here, we could do that. We could change how it runs when we run it. So if we wanted to just go back to once, or we could change the, if we were on the days, and we wanted to put an end date in here, we could do all that. In this case, I'll just cancel. And as this is stored on the database, we have another option here as well, which you can do from either the folder or the database side of things. If we look across the options here, we can schedule the app, different bits, we can update the app. So in this case, I'm just going to look at updating. So if it was updating, this is when I can actually go and re-get the latest version of this workflow. In this case, we don't have a later version, so I won't do that, but that's where you can make these changes. On this PC, we have the services running. So if I just go into services now, from a resilience point of view, the Alteryx service is running, which is running the queue, which is running the scheduler. And this is something that you'd probably want to monitor with some PC monitoring software, along with the disk space on this particular PC. That allows you to just have that little bit more resilience than running this from a laptop, reliant on it being turned on, or a desktop PC reliant on the power being turned on if you want to schedule overnight. Thank you for listening, and I hope you found this helpful.